Dear healthcare professionals and students, welcome to Healthcare Engineering. I am Sumita, a biomedical engineer from Healthcare Engineering team. We are here with amazing presentations to help you in learning new technologies, and we are going to share our knowledge and experiences what we gain from the industry. I strongly believe that all kind of healthcare professionals and students can learn a lot from our YouTube channel and blog by knowing the trends in modern healthcare world. Therefore, I would like to welcome you all to subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get instant updates of a new informative video. Also, you can visit our blog www.learnbiomedengine.blogspot.com to learn more on the concepts we share in our videos. We can help you out in advertising your healthcare products. We can promote your healthcare events. We can provide technical reviews for your medical devices as well, and many more online supports we provide to boost up your healthcare business. If you are interested to get support from us, please contact our admin to the given mail ID. We are also active in social media platforms, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, WhatsApp, Telegram and Instagram. And today's video is about optical coherence tomography. So this will be the part 1 video, and the part 2 video will be released soon. So let's get into the video. What is optical coherence tomography? Optical coherence tomography is an emerging non-invasive imaging technology for performing high-resolution cross-sectional or 3D images. This OCT or optical coherence tomography takes pictures of the back of an eye. Yes, it has revolutionized the clinical practice of ophthalmology by enhancing the patient care. The specialty of optical coherence tomography is that it detects eye problems prior to any symptoms present in the patient. It detects the early onset of a variety of eye conditions and eye diseases such as macular degeneration, glaucoma, and diabetic retinopathy, which are known to cause blindness. We will now see the optical coherence tomography technology. Optical coherence tomography is often described as it is analogous to ultrasound, which is nothing but it is similar to ultrasound technology. The major difference is optical coherence tomography uses light waves instead of sound waves for imaging. It is an excellent way to visualize the different layers of the retina. This optical coherence tomography also takes cross-section pictures of the distinctive layers of retina, layers of retinal nerve fibers and optic nerve head. Optical coherence tomography can also provide cross-sectional images of tissue structures in real time, and these structures of an eye are obtained on the micron scale. Optical coherence tomography is also used to detect diseases such as macular holes, hypertensive retinopathy, and even optic nerve damage. What are the clinical applications of optical coherence tomography? Optical coherence tomography functions as optical biopsy. Optical coherence tomography is used in combination with catheters and endoscopes for performing biopsy. This enables high-resolution imaging of organs in the system. Optical biopsy is considered as a powerful imaging technology for medical diagnostics because conventional procedures are hazardous. The optical coherence tomography also reduces sampling errors during the operation, and optical coherence tomography is used for guiding interventional surgical procedures. OCT techniques. The optical coherence tomography technique can be applied by two methods. The first one is the time domain OCT and another one is the spectral domain OCT. In an imaging system, there will be three means for scanning. One is to scan the object in depth and other two are used to scan transversely. 1D scans are labeled as A and T scans, while 2D scans are labeled as B and C scans. The A and T scans are one-dimensional, whereas B and C scans are two-dimensional. Now we will see the time domain OCT technique in detail. Time domain optical coherence tomography provides two-dimensional images of internal structures. The tissue information in depth is obtained by a mirror in the mobile reference arm which is moving. The acquisition speed of time domain optical coherence tomography is about 400 A scans per second and its axial resolution is about 810 microns. The next one is the spectral domain OCT. The spectral domain optical coherence tomography acquire entire A scans in reflected light at a given point in the tissue because it consists of a stationary reference arm with a central wavelength of about 800 to 850 nanometer. Therefore, in-depth information is transformed from frequency domain to time domain. The spectral domain optical coherence tomography has better ability to detect and monitor retinal diseases because of its ultra-high speed scan rate and higher resolution. Spectral domain optical coherence tomography can be implemented in two formats, Fourier domain OCT and swept source OCT. The acquisition speed of spectral domain OCT is about 25,000 to 50,000, 52,000 A scans per second and its axial resolution is 37 micron. What are the physical principles of optical coherence tomography? The first one is the tissue contrast in optical coherence tomography. Optical coherence tomography displays cross-sectional images of biological tissue. A near-infrared light is moderately focused into the tissue structures, whereas the light penetrates into the tissue and scatters back from the cell structures like nuclei, mitochondria, membranes, or collagen fibrils. These structures have different index of refraction than their surrounding and they form inhomogeneities in the refractive index of the tissue which gives rise to the scattering. The backscattered light is then analyzed in the optical coherence tomography system. The second principle is the interferometry as the depth measuring principle of optical coherence tomography. The optical coherence tomography utilizes the wave properties of light for depth measurement, namely the interference caused by superposition of the electrical field amplitude. The backscattered light is superimposed with a reference beam. Usually, this is accomplished by an interferometer setup such as the Michelson-type interferometer. Therefore, the superimposed beams show interference if the light of the two beams is coherent. This coherence depends on a fixed phase difference of the waves in the two arms of the interferometer. So, the main idea of optical coherence tomography is to use light sources with low coherence. So, in this case, there is only an apparent interference if the two arms of the interferometer are equally long. The coherence length is inversely proportional to the spectrum of the light. Therefore, optical coherence tomography uses spectrally broad light sources. The broader the spectrum of the light source, then there will be a better axial resolution. So, here is the image showing the OCT techniques based on Michelson interferometer. In time domain OCT, it uses the time delay and it is based on the encoding of the location of each reflection in the time information relating to the position of a moving reference arm mirror. But in the spectral domain detection technology, it is based on the use of Fourier transformation of the frequencies of light reflected. This acquires all information in a single axial scan through the tissue, and it also detects all light echoes from different delays by improving the imaging speed. The third principle of optical coherence tomography is the amplitude scan and brightness mode image. The envelope scan of the interference signal detector is called amplitude scan, also known as A-scan. This terminology is the same as in ultrasound sonography. The A-scan is a depth profile of scatters along the beam. The first surface reflection of the tissue mostly forms the highest peak, and then different layers in the tissue might be responsible for different amplitudes or interfaces. Because of the sensitivity for the reflectivity of the light is very high, the amplitude scans usually cover a dynamic range of more than 50 decibel. As in ultrasound, an image is formed by placing a row of A scans next to each other. In optical coherence tomography, this is usually done by scanning the beam transversely with scanning mirrors and optics. The amplitude of A scans is converted into gray values. The brightness of one pixel is related to the scattering amplitude at this position. And because of the interferometric measurement, there is a phenomenon called speckle, a granulation of the image, whereas the backscattering in the sample usually does not create a perfect wavefront. So there will be different scatterers in the volume formed by the focusing and the coherence grade. There is a mixture of constructive and destructive interference resulting in one pixel value, and in some cases, speckles are not just noise but may contain some information in their statistics. So far we have learnt part 1 of optical coherence tomography, and further details will be provided in the remaining part. You can visit our blog www.learnbiomedengine.blogspot.com for more information on this topic. To receive updates of a new video, please subscribe our YouTube channel, and you can reach out to us in the given mail ID. We are also active in other social media platforms, Facebook, LinkedIn, WhatsApp, Telegram, Twitter, and Instagram. So the remaining part of the optical coherence tomography video will be released soon. Stay tuned, and thank you for watching.